Up next, Simon Applebaum talks television. Several new series are starting this week, including Limitless, a new CBS show about the gift of superhuman intelligence. Or is it a gift? Take a look.
Can you remember what it's like to be inside your mother's womb? Have you ever thought about why people have to age? Is it inevitable? You're on the verge of having a life that most people can't even begin to imagine.
So wait, what the hell are you offering me? You're offering me one pill?
So what's it gonna be, Brian? You ready to become somebody who matters? This conversation is here and nowhere else. You describe it to your parents, the FBI, to anyone. I will let you die more painfully than you can fathom.
It doesn't look like there's a fast way out here. What if suddenly you knew how much strength you had in your hands? I mean exactly how much.
Hands in the air.
What if you could remember every documentary you ever saw? Every trig class? Could you do the math? Could you figure out exactly where that train is going to stop?
He knew the train was going to stop.
There's an explanation for what you saw today.
NZT-48.
The program was called off after the first two fatalities.
Find him.
Someone's killing these guys for their NZT. The first pill I took lasted about 12 hours. I have time to make one more move. I can't tell you who killed them,
but I can tell you a lot.
It's an arms race. Whoever created NZT may be out there giving it to anybody.
And every time he takes it, he basically becomes the smartest person in the world. That's a resource. Let's make it our resource. It's time.
It's about time you and me talked.
Okay, we have lots of TV to talk about, including the return of Kermit, Fozzie Bear, and Beaker in a show some people are saying isn't particularly family friendly. So without further ado, we want to get to our weekly roundup with Simon Applebaum, who hosts the podcast Tomorrow Will Be Televised.
Thank you, Brian Aaron, and hello, everyone. There's two words you can say about the Emmy Awards last night, and they're two big ones. One is stunning. It was stunning that HBO won four, count them, four of the most important awards, all of them for scripted television. Best comedy series for Veep, best drama series for Game of Thrones, more about that in a second, best limited series or miniseries for Olive Kitteridge, and best movie for Bessie, which was taken earlier in last week. And the other thing that was, you might say, was historic. Historic that Game of Thrones, a show that in previous years the Emmys would probably have never given a Best Drama Series award to because, oh, it's science fiction, oh, it's fantasy, oh, it's horror. We never give the big awards to shows like that, whether it was Twilight Zone or Star Trek or Battlestar Galactica. Well, Game of Thrones finally won, and it won big, 10 at least Emmys, the most from any other show. And it was also very important, too, that in history, there was African-American women that won the Supporting Actress Award, of course, for Ozzy Abdah for Orange is the New Black on Netflix, and of course, the brilliant speech that was given by Viola Davis last night that said it all about TV diversity that was quoted on all the morning shows this morning. Every person in the TV industry should take to heart what Viola said and expand diversity ASAP for people and women of color. Second thing on the agenda today, tomorrow night, three of the most anticipated shows on broadcast network television will be happening. You saw one of them a moment ago, and that's CBS's Limitless, based on the hit movie. Bradley Cooper is one of the executive producers, and yes, if you saw the clip, he will be an occasional performer. Then there is Scream Queens, the new series from Ryan Murphy of American Horror Story and Glee fame. Lea Michele, the co-star of Glee, is in it. She plays one of the sorority sisters, whose big sister, Jamie Lee Curtis, who has, of course, been involved in so many horror films herself, like the Halloween films. Well, they're all on the lookout for a killer who has a penchant for sorority folks. It is, as Murphy himself says, quite a bit of a satire on his work and on others in the horror genre. And finally, there is a show that will premiere tomorrow night at 8 o'clock on ABC. It is called The Muppets. And here's some of the Muppets at work.
No. No!
See, it's through. And.
No!
Can you keep a secret?
No.
Could you not stare at me?
Oh, sorry.
It's creeping me out.
Well, another day, another dollar.
Yep. We should probably ask for a raise.
Hold your horses. This isn't what I wanted. I need a rewrite. Otherwise, you're all going to be rewriting your resumes.
The Muppets and Scream Queens will premiere on ABC and Fox, respectively, at 8 p.m. Limitless will premiere on CBS at 10. And next week, Scream Queens will go from 2 hours for the premiere to 1 hour at 9. And, gentlemen, another show that will be premiering later this week is The Player, starring Wesley Snipes. It's NBC's big show, Thursdays at 10. And John Rogers, who is the creator and executive producer of that show, and The Librarians, coming back on TNT this fall, will be one of my guests on Tomorrow Be Televised, 3 o'clock on Blog Talk Radio. Also, we will have a wonderful gentleman named Cisco Suarez. He's the executive producer of Banda, the new hit Univision series on Sunday nights, had 3 million people catch the first one a week ago Sunday, and it's all about the search for the new Menudo, or Backstreet Boys, new boy band.
All right.
Yeah, all right.
So how did you do last night with your predictions versus reality?
Not great. No. I did get Jeffrey Tambor. Okay. If you watched the show last week, I did get Jeffrey Tambor for Best Actor in a Comedy for Transparent. Right. Jill Soloway did win Best Director. It was a big night for female directors. Jill Soloway won for Best Comedy Director. Also, Alicia Jarenko won for Olive Kitteridge on HBO for a limited series. But in terms of the big categories, I thought Transparent was going to win it, be a runaway for Amazon, be their first big super thing. Yeah. Unfortunately, it didn't happen. Veep won with the HBO onslaught. I was very surprised that Game of Thrones won. I thought it was going to be another show. And on and on. But I'm happy to say that even though American Crime, which was my pick to win a lot of Emmys last night, Regina, and the week before didn't, Regina King, who was wonderful last night, along with Viola Davis, she did win for Best Supporting Actress in a limited series. And I'm hoping that next year it will get more.
And network took it on the nose, though, because cable cleaned up, right?
Cable took it all the way. And if you count also Netflix, which had one for Orange, and then the two that Amazon won, it was pretty much a runaway. At one point, if you're watching the Fox telecast last night, HBO won like 6 or 7 Emmys in a row. NBC won one, which was the reality competition one for The Voice. CBS was shut out. Good Wife did not win anything, which was the one big broadcast player.
We love that show.
And NBC did win. They were the second place. HBO won over comparing, including, I should say, last week's Creative Arts Emmys, last night's show. They won over 40 Emmy Awards, which I think is their best performance ever. And NBC was second with 12, although one was only on last night.
ABC got Shark Tank, too. They had the best structured reality. It's interesting. My hubs likes it. Yeah.
What was the most surprising thing for you?
It was Game of Thrones. was Game of Thrones winning it. And I was also surprised as well that it won big.
Yeah.
It won writing. It won directing. George R. R. Martin has to be smiling. You saw him in the seats.
I love Peter Dinklage.
Yes, I do too. I saw him in a wonderful movie several years ago that was critically acclaimed that you just knew this was a sensational actor. But I have to say, the other pleasant surprise was what Viola Davis said. Because at a time when we are looking more and more at diversity in the television industry, and there are still are, as I mentioned, I think last week, we still have the studies that of all episodic television, even with all the diversity coming in, even with Netflix, Hulu, and Amazon coming in, we still have 11 to 13% of people of color write direct episodes, 1% are women of color, maybe as much as 70% women, that we had female directors finally win in a major way, but we had Viola Davis wrap it up and say, we got to do better. But Senator Breen way using Harriet Tubman.
And like she talked about opportunity, because it's not like that part that she plays in one for could have been played by anyone. It wasn't written as, well, Shonda is a genius anyway. She's changed the whole game. But how can we have a show like Game of Thrones where there's dragons and all these worlds, but you can't conceive of a person who's not white in any of these parts?
Like, and that's amazing because science fiction and fantasy series have had a very good track record of minority actors, and in some cases, writers and directors and producers behind the scene.
Yeah.
You look at Star Trek. You look at Battlestar Galactica. You look at 12 Monkeys. You look at many of the shows are on sci-fi.
Yeah.
They have the very diverse cast. In some cases, they have diversity behind the scene. And, of course, The Walking Dead, which I think has been a model of diversity off the bat, not only in terms of the cast, but people like Ernest Dickerson, Spike Lee's cinematographer, being one of the key directors, and Hispanic writers and directors also involved with that show. And that's also the same with Fear the Walking Dead, both on AMC. The other thing, too, that was great was Jon Hamm. Finally winning. It was great to see at long last two of the best acting performances of the last decade.
The arc.
Jon Hamm, and before that, Bryan Cranston win.
But a lot of it seemed like the goodbye show, like the Daily Show got too many awards, in my opinion. It's so overrated.
Agreed. I thought John Oliver should have won for Last Week Tonight.
But it was the goodbye tour. It was like, everyone who's leaving, this is our last chance to make it up to you for all the times you got snubbed.
Yeah. I saw that clip of all the goodbyes, everything from the Jon Hamm, to Craig Ferguson. And I'm happy Craig Ferguson, by the way, got in the Late Late Show, which I think should have gotten some Emmys nominations for his last week, last year. But it was nice to see that. It was nice to see, like, the Emmys come full circle.
And it was nice to see Brooklyn guy, Tracy Morgan, closing out the show.
That was an incredible surprise. Kudos to his publicist, who suggested to the Emmy people, the Television Academy, let's have Tracy on. He was funny. And we should also point out that there was a Brooklyn winner, The Americans, which is shot here in Brooklyn. Margot Martindale, the wonderful actress who won the Emmy a year or two ago for Justified, was on The Americans, won that too.
Thank you,
there
Margo.
We go. Brooklyn.
Bring it back to Brooklyn.